Hi, this is Sarah Marks, one of the librarians here at UMass Lowell. Today we're going to talk about the different types of scholarly literature available, specifically the difference between formal and gray literature. When we talk about formal literature, we're talking about articles that go through the peer review process. This includes general peer review articles, empirical studies, review articles, systematic reviews, and meta-analyses. The gray literature is a little different. This is a name for non-formally published articles and documents that are scholarly and substantive, which means that people have put time and effort into them, found sources to support points, but they're not going through that formal peer review process. And it's sometimes difficult to tell if something has gone through it. In most of our databases, you're going to find the theses and dissertations that fit into the gray literature. These are written by masters, PhD, sometimes upper-level undergraduates, but they're published in the sense that we at universities store them and put them online. Very often, the text is not available. Now, the best ones will be taken and broken up and reformatted into some type of scholarly article. If you're doing a quick paper, you're probably going to avoid the gray literature, specifically theses and dissertations. But when you're doing your own in-depth research or your own thesis or dissertation, you might want to look at these. But they fit into that gray literature. The same goes for technical reports, working papers, white papers. They're all sort of the same thing. The experts are writing them, and sometimes because the peer review process takes forever to happen, they're published online quickly so that they get out there. This is especially done with current and sort of hot topics that we really need to talk about in a different way than just the peer review process. Conference proceedings often do get a peer review to a degree, but they're not formal papers. The peer review process does allow for some articles to be pre-printed ahead of their formal publication. This is often done before the full edit happens, just so that people can start getting a sense of what the research is talking about. But they're considered pre-print, thus part of the gray literature. Patents are often used in some research, but they're just patents that people have applied for and approved. And finally, anything written by a think tank, a policy institute, a nonprofit, this includes non-government organizations, both American and international, these might have a lot of solid research in them, but when you're asked to get peer review articles, nothing in the gray literature will count. That being said, if you're doing something where you need a fuller scope of the research, don't forget the gray literature. At the very least, they'll help you identify other sources that you can go and visit and consider using for your research. So that's the type of scholarly literature available. If you have any questions, feel free to ask us. We're happy to help.